of hell than the day of Arafat. This is the 9th of Dhul Hijjah. He draws near, then praises them to the angels, saying, what do they want? So these are special times, special places, many of them associated with the prophets of Allah, the beloved servants of Allah, at which Allah Ta'ala has provided opportunities for his servants to draw near to him, to obtain proximity to him, by being in a place where a dua was accepted, being there at a time when a dua was accepted. And so this place of Arafat, Jabal al-Rahma, is the place where the tawbah of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, the father of humanity, was accepted. And so this is a great opportunity for us on this occasion and for the Hujjaj Kiram at this location to seek forgiveness from Allah. And tawbah is that door of Allah Ta'ala's mercy which never closes. And it is represents hope for the servant that although he has deviated from the command of Allah, yet Allah will accept his repentance, reward it as a good deed, and provide him with further opportunities to show his loyalty and to be obedient. The door of tawbah is never closed, and this gives us hope for the future. And so by providing these opportunities in the Eidain, when Allah Ta'ala wipes away these sins, and in one narration it is mentioned that the fast of the day of Arafat is the expiation of the sins of the year preceding and the year following. So by providing these opportunities to give the servant a clean slate, he renews the servant's opportunity to begin again, hopefully, with a new approach, with an aspiration to complying with the commands of Allah, knowing that he is not burdened with the debt of past disobedience. And the sacrifice which is particularly associated with this Eid, this is the sunnah of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. And in it, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as we'll read in the khutbah, there is a reward for each hair of the sacrifice. Can you count hair? Can you count hairs? Every hair of the sacrifice on the skin, when you see the amount of hair. So Allah Ta'ala, meaning it's uncountable, uncountable rewards. And the mas'ala here to remember is that sacrifice must be after the Salatul Eid. So if you have given instructions for someone to slaughter the animal before the Salatul Eid, this doesn't fulfill your obligation. After the Salatul Eid, or in the 2 days after as well, you have time. So also the 11th and the 12th, these are also opportunities. 10th, 11th and 12th, you have these 3 days to perform the sacrifice. So just to mention a few verses from Surah Al-Hajj, chapter 22 of the Quran, in which the topic of Hajj and the topic of sacrifice is mentioned, just to see how Allah Ta'ala talks about these sacred moments in the Quran. And he said in verse 26 of Surah Al-Hajj, so verse 26 of chapter 22, he said, وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا وَطَّحِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْقَائِمِينَ وَالرُّكَّعِ السُّجُودِ. So the first thing is that Allah Ta'ala mentions in the Quran the time when he established this house, the Kaaba, by asking Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, commanding Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam to establish it as a place of worship, to re-establish it as a place of worship. Worship. Why? أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا. So that it should be a place where people would worship one God alone. That the concept of Tawheed should be reinforced, should be revived through the worship of one God at the sacred house. وَطَحِّرْ بَيْتِي, and cleanse my house. The place where Allah is remembered should be clean. We clean the mosques, we clean our own homes, and even keep our tongues clean. Because these are places where the name of Allah is mentioned. So keep your tongue clean. Next time you think of swearing or lying or cheating, keep your tongue clean as well, because these are places where the name of Allah is mentioned. وَطَّحِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ, for those who will do tawaf around the Kaaba, وَالْقَائِمِينَ, those who will stand in prayer, وَالْرُكَّعِ السُّجُودِ, those who will bow and those who will prostrate for Allah. And then he gave Ibrahim alayhi salam this command. And think, at that time this was an uncultivated valley and this was a place where it was very hard to get food or even water. And he goes there, he's commanded to go there with his wife and his young child, very young child. And you see, many of you have seen how a young child is completely helpless, completely dependent. And what a parent feels in their heart when they can't fulfill the need of that baby, it's a great test. So he went there, and this is a lesson in tawakkul, that he went there solely at the command of Allah. You wouldn't think of traveling by aeroplane in an air-conditioned airport today with a newborn babe. You would think twice, can he endure the journey? And here he is going to a place where there are no people, no food, no water even, in reliance that Allah has commanded me and he will provide. And then Allah Ta'ala gives him this command, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍ عَمِيقٍ. And this is a great lesson for us as well. In tawakkul, that when we work for the sake of Allah, then Allah Ta'ala brings things to fruition which are beyond our imagination. Beyond our imagination. When we make effort, we think, how will my small effort make a difference? How is this ever going to come to pass? Sometimes the goals that we see ahead of us seem so unattainable that we think, what can one person, what difference can we make in the world? What change can we bring about? And yet you see in the example of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what can be achieved in 23 years? If you think of a person going against their culture, going against the traditions of the tribe, in a tribal culture, going against the religion that is established at that time by the people there, it seemed like a cause that had very little chance of taking off. And then you see him at the time of the migration, alone in a cave with one companion, with the tribes, people from all of the tribes pursuing him for assassination. And you see, how will this mission ever come to be? And yet we see, sure enough, 23 years after he proclaims his prophethood, we see that Islam is established in the Arabian Peninsula and the Kaaba is in the custodianship of the Muslims. And the great chieftains of Mecca have become Muslim or have died attempting to oppose the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His mission is accomplished in only 2 decades. This is a remarkable achievement. And here we see Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam goes to an empty valley where there is no food and water, and Allah Ta'ala says, call the people for Hajj. And you would think, what is the purpose of calling people for Hajj in this place where there is nobody, where there is nothing to feed or give water to the people who come here? Who will hear that call? But yet when you look today, this is this promise of Allah, يَأْتُوكَ, they will come. They will come to you. Is being fulfilled until the day of judgment. Every year, millions of people. First hundreds, then thousands, then tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands. Today, millions of people are coming to the Kaaba every year in response to this call. That's the change that the effort of one man can bring about if he is devoted to Allah's cause. And then Allah Ta'ala mentioned about the sacrifice, that the people should witness manafi'a lahum, the benefits for them, that this gift of the animals which Allah Ta'ala gave them is a tremendous benefit that Allah has given them. Through it they find food and carriage, the animals you'd carry them, and also they use the skin to make their tents or their homes as well. So they provided shelter, food and carriage for them, all through the animals. And they could drink the milk of the animals as well. If the animals would eat the foliage, they could drink the milk of the animals. So drink as well they got from the animals. Everything for them in the desert was, for example, from the camel. It was a means of sustenance for them. So Allah Ta'ala says that through these occasions of Eid, through these reminders, that people should remember the blessings that He has bestowed upon them, the blessings that we have through the animals. And what should we do then? وَيَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهِ. And we should mention the name of Allah, because people used to sacrifice in the name of idols. So they would enjoy the benefits given to them by Allah and mention the name of the idols. So Allah Ta'ala said no. Mention only the name of Allah, enjoy the benefits given by Allah, and remember the name of Allah. وَيَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ. Because He has given them food. رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. Through these animals. فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا. So eat from it, i.e. enjoy the benefits. وَأَطْئِمُ الْبَائِسَ الْفَقِيرِ. And also feed those who are in need. Because they also need to enjoy the benefits. So use the benefits and share the benefits. And then he talks about the rituals of Hajj. And he says, ذلك ومن يعظم حرمات الله فهو خير له عند ربه. He says that whoever is mindful of the prohibitions of Allah, this is better for him with his Lord. And so this is a time also to remember what Allah has prohibited, i.e. shirk. And also that you should eat halal. As he mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah, he gave with detail all the animals which you are allowed to eat. So this is a reminder to eat what is halal and to leave what is haram. And then he says, وَعُهِلَّتْ لَكُمُ الْأَنْعَامِ, and that he has made the animals lawful for them. And he says, وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. He said, فَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ. So avoid, abstain from the uncleanliness of idols, وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ, and also from bad speech. So meaning that you should eat what is halal, you should avoid shirk, and you should avoid bad speech as well. حنفاء لله غير مشركين به, steadfast, upright, for the sake of Allah, associating none with him. And then he says further on, ذلك ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب, that whoever is respectful towards the signs of Allah, these places associated with Allah, these times associated with Allah, even the animal which is going to be sacrificed for the sake of Allah, فَإِنَّهَا مِن تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ, this is from the taqwa, God consciousness of the heart. And he reminds them, the people, that they have benefits in the animals. And he says, وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكًا, for every nation we prescribed such rites or rituals, لِيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ, that they may mention the name of Allah, عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ, upon the animals which he has given them as a means of sustenance. You see, at the time of the mentioning the fasting of the month of Ramadan, he said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, as it was prescribed on those preceding you. Here, when he mentioned the sacrifice, he says, وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكًا, for every nation we prescribed the festival of a sacrifice in the name of Allah. So this is showing the continuity of our religions, that Allah's religion from the beginning of time has had these same elements: fasting, sacrifice, zakat, social obligations, tawheed. All of this is God's religion. And the Prophet ﷺ even said, one of the things he was told to say is, وَلَمَا كُنْتُ بِدْعًا بِرَسُولٍ, I'm not the first messenger that has come to you. My coming here is not a new thing. Messengers have come before me. And the similar religion has also been proclaimed before me by those messengers. And then he says, فَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ فَلَهُ أَسْلِمُوا, your Lord is one God, so submit only to him. وَبَشِّرِ الْمُخْبِتِينَ, glad tidings for the مُخْبِتِينَ. Who are they? Who are they? Listen to these qualities. These are the qualities which Allah Ta'ala mentions in the Quran here. He says, when you worship only one God and you submit to him, he says, وَبَشِّرِ الْمُخْبِتِينَ, الَّذِينَ, those people, إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ, when Allah's name is mentioned, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, their hearts tremble. Their hearts tremble at the fear, out of fear of the consequences of disobeying him. وَالصَّابِرِينَ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَهُمْ, and those who are patient with what has been, what they are afflicted with. When you feel trials and tribulations, you remain steadfast and you believe firmly in Allah. Loss of health, loss of wealth, loss of children, loss of loved ones, these are all tests. وَالْمُخِيمِ الصَّلَاةِ, those who establish the prayer. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, and when Allah gives them plentiful rizq, they spend, share the blessings with those who are in need. So these are some of the lessons that we have from the Hajj and also from the sacrifice. Allah Ta'ala says, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُهُمُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ, that the blood, the flesh is not what reaches Allah, but it is rather your taqwa, your remembrance of Allah, your obedience to Allah, which is what he is concerned with. So just to mention a couple of things here, that from the Fajr of the 9th of Zulhijjah, which is yesterday, to the Asr of the 13th of Zulhijjah, after every prayer, inshallah, you should read three times the takbirs that we recite on the day of Eid. And also on this day of Eid, you should continuously recite these takbirat and go home by a different route, also reciting the takbirat as much as you can. The manner of the Salatul Eid, inshallah, we will stand up to read two rakat Salatu Eid. This is a Sunnah prayer, but the takbirat are wajib. So we said with six additional takbirat, wajib takbirs. And three of them will be in the first rakat, preceding the Surah Al-Fatiha. And three of them will be in the second rakat, just before we go into the ruku, after the recitation of Quran, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum, respected all. Eid Mubarak to you and also whose families have been performing Hajj. As you know, there was very, I think, restricted people. Only the residents of Saudi Arabia could perform the Hajj. Somebody have dropped their mobile. It's an iPhone. On the way up, it was just near the shoe area. So please check if you have dropped your mobile. Check your pockets. It looks like somebody young who have dropped the mobile. So I'll leave it here. On your way out, please take it from here. I'll just leave it there. I think Haji Sahib is doing the collection, and inshallah, our Dr. Shafiuddin Sahib will let you know the procedure of the Eid prayer, the total rakat. And remember, there's a khutbah after the Eid prayer, which Imam Sahib will tell you the importance of the khutbah. On your way out, you all got your bags with your shoes. Please don't dump them outside when you leave. Take the bags with you. Try and hug only those who are within your bubbles, like your family, your immediate family. Try not to hug the people who are not from your bubbles or friends. By all means, you can do it outside. And once the namaz and the prayer is finished, if you can leave ASAP, so the second Jamaat people can come in. Also, on your way out, there are all these contactless machines for the donation. Please donate generously, and jazakumullah khair.
So, inshallah, as Haji Sahib was saying, after the Salatul Eid has been performed, inshallah, there will be the khutbah of Eid. Please, unless you have a compelling reason, stay. Don't disrupt the recitation of the khutbah and benefit from the mention of the Quran and the hadith, which is in the khutbah. And then after that, inshallah, we'll do a short dua and you may return to your homes, inshallah. And remember to be extra kind towards your families today. It's a day of blessings, and make sure you take the happiness with you wherever you go. This is something which Allah Ta'ala mentions so much in the Quran. It's an area which I've studied as well. The rights of people, huquq al-ibad, is so emphasized in the Quran. And it's very important that we remember today to make the burden light on our families, try to give as much as we can to our friends, our relatives, and our family members, and not worry so much about what we are taking from people. Make the burden light on people and make it an occasion of happiness. Do whatever we can to spread a little bit of happiness, and also to give gifts. Of course, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Tahaddu, tahabbu." Tahaddu meaning you will exchange hadiyah, you will exchange gifts. Tahaddu. He said, "Tahabbu." Through that, you will exchange love. This is the beautiful eloquence of the Prophet ﷺ. Two words, and very symmetrical, and sounding similar, and yet this lesson that he gave us, even at the time of marriage. When you exchange gifts, the purpose is to increase love between the families which are about to have a relationship. But it's used for the opposite purpose, in fact. So we should remember this exchanging of gifts. This is all part of increasing love amongst people. And this is the great purpose. That's why even if a relationship doesn't work out, Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, don't take it back. Even if you've given a mountain of wealth, don't take it back. Because you don't want to make things acrimonious. So this is the purpose of gifts on Eid, and also all of the occasions that we celebrate, that there is tremendous hikmah in these rituals. They're not empty rituals. There's a purpose to them, and we shouldn't lose sight of that, inshallah. Inshallah, we'll stand for the prayer now. inshallah, we should be on time and make our intentions. Remembering to switch off, please, all your mobile phones and standing in straight rows, leave a space between each of you as has been announced. Yeah, we'll wait 2 minutes, that's fine. We'll start on time, inshallah. Make your intention and clear your mind and your heart from worldly thoughts and desires and loves. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين
اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد سبحان الله الجليل الأكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد عدد من وقف بعرفات ورمى الجمرات وضحى ونحر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله الذي جعل لكل أمة منسكا ليذكروا اسم الله على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام وعلم التوحيد وأمر بالإسلام، وأعاد علينا عوائد فضله التي تعود في كل عيد وتظهر، ومد لنا موائد كرمه، وزكى أبداننا من درن السيئات وطهر. فرحم الله عبدا عظم الله وكبر، أحمده حمدا كثيرا واشكره شكرا جميلا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له رب العالمين، الذي جعل لكل شيء وقتا وأجلا مقدرا. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد المرسلين، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأهل بيته الطاهرين وبارك وسلم كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فيا أيها الإخوان، توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه من كل عصيان، واعلموا أن يومكم هذا يوم شريف وعيد مبارك منيف، فضله الله تعالى وشرفه، فسبحان من أوضح لنا السبيل، وخص أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بالغرة والتحجيل، وامتحن نبيه إبراهيم الخليل بذبح ولده إسماعيل. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. قال أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: يا رسول الله، ما هذه الأضاحي؟ قال: سنة أبيكم إبراهيم عليه السلام. قالوا: فما لنا فيها يا رسول الله؟ قال: بكل شعرة حسنة. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما عمل ابن آدم من عمل يوم النحر أحب إلى الله من إهراق الدم، وإنه ليأتي يوم القيامة بقرونها وأشعارها وأظلافها، وإن الدم ليقع من الله بمكان قبل أن يقع بالأرض فطيبوا بها نفسا. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: من وجد سعة لأن يضحي فلم يضحي فلا يحضر مصلانا. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. فالبدنة عن سبع، والبقرة عن سبع، والشاة عن واحد، ولا ذبح إلا من بعد صلاة العيد في يوم النحر وبعده يومين. ويستحب التصرف ثلث لنفسه، وثلث هدية، وثلث للفقراء والمساكين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. فيا عباد الله، رحمكم الله، عظموا شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب، وتوبوا من الذنوب وأدوا الفرائض والحقوق، فإن الله ذاكر لمن ذكر وشاكر لمن شكر. أعاد الله علينا بركة هذا العيد، وآمنا من سوء يوم الوعيد، وجعلنا من الذين لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون، وشرفنا بالحج والأمرة وزيارة النبي المختار صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله الأبرار وأصحابه الأخيار إلى يوم القرار، برحمته هو أرحم الراحمين. والحمد لله رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والبدن جعلناها لكم من شعائر الله لكم فيها خير، فاذكروا اسم الله عليها صواف، فإذا وجبت جنوبها فكلوا منها وأطعموا القانع والمعتر، كذلك سخرناها لكم لعلكم تشكرون. بارك الله لنا ولكم بالقرآن العظيم، ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم، إنه تعالى جواد كريم، ملك قديم، بر رؤوف رحيم، ورب حليم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله، سيد الخلائق والبشر، أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى، ومن يعص الله ورسوله فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. أما بعد، فيا أيها الناس، اتقوا الله العظيم كما أمر، وانتهوا عما نهاكم عنه وزجر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد، عدد من صلى وصام، وعدد من قعد وقام، صلى الله عليه وعلى جميع الأنبياء خير البشر وملائكته المقربين والخلفاء الراشدين، خصوصاً على خير البشر بعد الأنبياء بالتحقيق، أمير المؤمنين سيدنا أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه، وعلى مزين المنبر والمحراب الناطق بالصواب أمير المؤمنين سيدنا أبي حفظ عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه، وعلى جامع القرآن كامل الحياء والإيمان من المؤمنين سيدنا عثمان بن أفان رضي الله تعالى عنه، وعلى أسد الله الغالب مظهر العجائب والغرائب من المؤمنين سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه وكرم الله وجهه، وعلى الإمامين الهمامين السعيدين الشهيدين أبي محمد الحسن وأبي عبد الله الحسين رضي الله تعالى عنهما، وعلى أمهما سيدة النساء فاطمة الزهراء رضي الله تعالى عنها، وعلى عميه المكرمين عند الله والناس سيدنا أبي أمارة الحمزة وسيدنا أبي الفضل العباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما، وعلى الستة الباقية من العشرة المبشرة وسائر المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان والتابعين الأخيار وأولياء أمته الأبرار إلى يوم القرار رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولأساتذتنا ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين بالإمام العادل ناصر الإسلام والملة والدين. اللهم انصر من نصر دين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون، واذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وهم وتم وأكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام وإليك يرجع السلام، حينا ربنا بالسلام وأدخلنا الجنة دار السلام. تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة، والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار يا مجير يا مجير يا مجير. اللهم احفظنا من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة، وأنت خير الحافظين، فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة بغير حساب، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار، يا عزيز يا غفار يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وإيمانا كاملا وعملا مقبولا ويقينا صادقا وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا ورزقا واسعا حلالا طيبا يا الله، وشفاء من كل داء، وتوبة نصوحا، وتوبة قبل الموت، وراحة عند الموت، والعفو عند الحساب، والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم أجرنا من النار يا مجير يا مجير يا مجير. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهما 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 كما ربياني صغيرا. اللهم ارحم أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر لأمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. اللهم يسر أمورنا وأمور المسلمين في كل بلاد العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصرهم، اللهم أيدهم، اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين. آمين يا رب العالمين، آمين يا رب العالمين. Ya Allah, your servants are gathered in your house for your remembrance on this blessed day of Eid. Ya Allah, accept their Salatul Eid, accept their fasts of the month of Zulhijjah, their ibadat of the month of Zulhijjah. Ya Allah, accept their fasts of the day of Arafat. Ya Allah, accept the Hajj rituals of the Hujjaj Kiram at Makkatul Mukarramah, in Mina, Muzdalifa, in Arafat. Ya Allah, accept all of their du'as and their efforts for your pleasure. Ya Allah, make all of this
a means of our coming near to you, coming close to you, and earning your mercy. Ya Allah, make it a means of us earning the intercession of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the Day of Judgment. Ya Allah, through your mercy, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, through the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Allah, have mercy upon you, the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, do not deny us the vision of your blessed place on the Day of Judgment. Ya Allah, make the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pleased with us and do not make him disappointed with us. Ya Allah, give us tawfiq to do good deeds in the remaining moments of our lives. Ya Allah, give us death in the state of Iman. Ya Allah, join us with the righteous in the hereafter. Ya Allah, make our young ones pious. Ya Allah, make them follow in the footsteps of the pious elders. Ya Allah, make our protect our elderly. Ya Allah, teach us to respect them and honor them as they deserve. And Ya Allah, have mercy upon their weakness, Ya Allah. Have mercy upon their age, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you to heal those who are sick and afflicted around the world, especially in these times. Ya Allah, we ask ease for those who are troubled and in hardship, who are burdened by debt or a lack of rizq. Ya Allah, increase their rizq. Ya Allah, ease the troubles of all those who are afflicted around the world. Ya Allah, especially those who have been affected by wars, by poverty, by famine, by droughts, by weather conditions. Ya Allah, we ask you to create ease for them. Ya Allah, make a way out for them. Ya Allah, keep them steadfast in their iman. Ya Allah, help us to help them as much as is in our power and our control. Ya Allah, give tawfiq to the leaders around the world to increase peace and harmony amongst the people and the communities of the world and increase the understanding of people towards each other, their understanding and their love for each other within our families, within our communities, within our nations and across the globe. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta samiul alim wa tub alina ya maulana innaka anta التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عيد مبارك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.